My geography class. This is the fifth class of our geography, the chapter number one, environment. In that, the fifth class is going to be go, and in this class, we are going to talk and discuss about the environment chapter. In the environment chapter, our last point is remaining to talk about the human environment and ecosystem. So, moving further to discuss about what is human environment and what is ecosystem. So, today our topic of discussion is speaking about topic number 5, what is ecosystem and what is human environment. So, in this we will see about what is ecosystem and what is human environment. Our these topic is the last topic which makes a very important role in our day-to-day life. First one, the ecosystem, the greenery you are seeing, the world you are seeing, the earth you are seeing. So, we will talk and discuss about what is ecosystem. So, what is ecosystem? Let's see what is ecosystem. So, here the ecosystem is the system formed by the interaction. So, here we are talking about the word interaction. Interaction of what? All the living organisms each other and within the physical and chemical factors of environment in which they all live, and there is a transfer of energy and material. So that is going to be called as ecosystem. So moving further to see what is ecosystem in detail, we are moving to again the flashback. Our story was started with the Ravi was going to the school and observing the certain changes in the atmosphere in their area, and he was shocked. So again moving to the same class, this is the story again starting at NCC camp. So at the NCC camp, what was the story? Let's see. That Ravi's class was attending. Jesse exclaimed, "What a heavy downpour. It reminds me my home in Kerala." So Jesse, residing in Kerala, all the time used to have the heavy precipitation over there. So the heavy rainfall over there. You should come and see how the pours and pours and pours over the lush green field and the coconut plantation. That means all together talking about the greenery of Kerala. Heavy rainfall over there. And there the one of the major crop that is the coconut plantation. Next we are talking about this all greenery part. So why? Who is explaining to whom? So Ravi and Ravi classmate Jesse. So Jesse is telling about the greenery of Kerala. Next, Hira from Jaisalmer. So as we are talking about Hira from Jaisalmer, Jaisalmer is situated in Rajasthan. So Rajasthan, we are knowing about, the area is also having the desert, the Thar desert, the Great Indian desert. So we get no rains. We get no rain. That means one specific feature of the desert, there is a very less rainfall. And that's why it is turned into the desert. So we see only kikar. Kikar means a type of a tree, thorny tree. Then sand. And if I am talking about sand, you should not forget about camels. So sand as far as the eyes can see, but you can also find camels, said Ravi. So camel is also known as the ship of desert. So finally we are talking about their environment, their ecosystem over there, how they are managing. So somewhere there is a heavy rainfall and somewhere there is no rainfall. So we are talking about the two areas, Jaisalmer, present in Rajasthan and having the desert, and Kerala, there is a full of greenery. So moving further, what the story is telling. Hira saying, not just camel, if you visit our desert. So Hira is telling, not only the camel who is there, the desert you will see snakes, lizard and many insects too. So these are also lurking creatures and insects and animals over there. Ravi wondered, why do they animals, the vegetation and the way people live vary from place to place. So here Ravi is wondering and thinking about one question. Ravi wondered, why do animals and the vegetation and the way the people live vary place to place? Are they all related? that was the question. By whom? By Ravi to the teacher. And the teacher was replying, yes, very much so. The teacher replied. Ravi is asking what? About the vegetation, about the climate, about the area surrounding is different from his place to other place. And the reason why we are going to see. Now the teacher will explain. Here, all animals, plants, human beings depends upon each other, immediate surrounding. Often they are interdependent on each other. This relation between the living organism as well as the relation between the organism and their surrounding forms an ecosystem. So there could be an ecosystem of a large rainforest, grassland, desert, mountain, lake, river, ocean, even a small pond. So if we are talking about a small pond also, with the help of the small pond, I am going to explain you about the ecosystem. So how every area is varied from other. They will have, in Jammu and Kashmir, we are having the cold climate, snowfall. In Kerala, there is too much hot. In Rajasthan, there is still too much hot. Like that, the climate is varying from here and there. So we will see with the help of the photograph. Upside the question is there. Do you think the park in which Ravi and his friend played formed an ecosystem? So yes, that was an ecosystem. So this is the photograph taken from the NCERT textbook, figure number 1.3, a pond and an ecosystem. So in the pond, what we are observing? So in the pond, we are observing the trees, water, ducks, flowers, then animals, the grass and everything. So land is there, air is there, water is there, and living organisms, they are interacting, and there is a balance of energy forming one and there. Then this pond is an ecosystem. So this ecosystem is very important. If the labor and transfer of energy is going to be disturbed, so everything is going to be disturbed in this nature. Next, the topic is human environment. So what is human environment? So we will talk and discuss about human environment. So here we will see human being interact with the environment and modify it according to their need. Early human adapt themselves to the natural surrounding. But now here what we are doing? So we are modifying day by day all the things. So here we are having the textbook. This textbook is coming from where? From the trees the textbook is coming. So plus like that, the trees which are very essential to us, if we will cut into more number and fulfill our demands, so that demands are going to lead into the greediness, and that is going to be a very very disaster to our environment. So human environment is very important. As in my two presentation I was talking about to do the responsibility, the dharma, the right conduct, and having the cleanliness next to godliness. As the two point was speaking, here the human environment is very important, because due to our need, and our need is making this environment to be modified according to us. As in our class, we are seeing this wooden table. This wooden tables come from where? From the environment. Our need was that a table. We cut it down and we convert it into wooden plank, and then the table is present here. So like that, modified it. Who is modifying and for what purpose? Human beings require the place to do agriculture. So they clear the land piece on that the huge forest were there. So the large amount of forest was cut down to do the agriculture. The forest was cleared to make the homes. So modification in the environment. The human adopted themselves and made their surrounding. They led a simple life and fulfilled their requirement from the nature around them. Within the time, needs grew. That means the need is increasing and increasing. The reason why the need is increasing, because the population explosion is going on. Population day by day increasing. So we require many more things. So we are taking all from the environment and become more varied. Human learn new ways to use and change environment. Now we are knowing about in Rajasthan too much hotness is there. So that much hotness is there, hot climate is there. To make it comfortable, we are using the fans, we are using ACs, we are using coolers and making our environment over there clean. The atmosphere, we are changing the atmospheric condition of that particular room. So human beings learn new ways to use and change the environment. How to change it, to grow more number of the trees, to make the environment to be very good for their comfortable. Moving further to see this. They learn to grow the forest were there, they cut it down the forest, they learn to grow crops. The animals which were earlier known as wild animal, they learn to domesticate them. So this domestication of the animal, and after that they slowly slowly settle their life. So in the part of their history, step by step already we had discussed and learned about how the human settlement came. How slowly, slowly human beings started to settle their life. Earlier they used to take the nomad life. They used to move from one place to another, one place to another. So moving further, the meat was invented, plus food was produced. The barter system, this barter system we will discuss in the next class. The barter system, the trade, then they started to commerce, develop industrial revolution and animal large-scale production. Transportation become faster, information revolution and rail communication and speedily across the world. By all this paragraph, it's clear about with the human need, we are changing environment and we are setting ourselves to be in the more comfort zone so that we can enjoy our life happily. But due to, as I stated about, few people's greed to earn more profit, to have a more production, so they started to exploit the environment. So the main teaching of this, all the chapters, the main teaching is very important, that the conservation of environment. So moving further to discuss about what the human environment is talking about. Human environment created by human only, by how the environment they modified it and they made their own environment. And according to their needs, they started to grow crops. According to their needs, they started to use animals for the meat, flesh, eggs and all. For their settled life, they started to clear the patch of land and they started to make their homes and they started to reside. They started to do more innovation, that is innovation of wheel, barter system, trading, commerce, development, industry and all. Now the world is moving very rapidly in the process of technology. So this all information revolution is moving fast and communication. Today with the help of a smartphone, just we are clicking here, we are talking to anyone in any part of the world. So this is the information revolution and communication system. So moving further to see, have you ever thought why you love eating a juicy watermelon in summer and hot roasted peanuts in winter? The question is here. First point, the juicy watermelon in summer and the hot roasted peanuts in the winter. Both the word winter and summer are the name of the two seasons. Summer, the climate is very, very hot. The winter, the climate is very, very cold. So due to that, our taste is changing. A perfect balance is necessary between a natural and a human environment. That's why whenever the winter season is here, we are wearing woolen clothes. When summer are there, we are wearing cotton clothes. So we have to adjust and make a balance so we can reside in the environment. So natural and human environment. Human must learn to live and use their environment in a harmonious way. So the word is speaking harmonious, making a perfect balance. How to use and when to use, in which way. So this whole topic is talking about the human environment. Human is creating its own environment with its comfort. So the comfort should not create the disharmony to the environment. So moving further, Nuri, a girl from Mizoram. The story again attached to this. The story is speaking about a Nuri girl from Mizoram. From Ravi's class, in Ravi's class, one of the girls is there. Her name is Nuri and she is belonging from Mizoram. She is also talking about what? The lush green surrounding of her place. Seeing Ravi upset, having lost his playground. The playground, we started our story with the playground. Ravi was upset because the playground was totally dug up. And on the ground, there is a huge construction was there. So the residential area is going to be set up. The huge building with the many flats. Nuri invited him to visit her home state during the upcoming vacation. So the upcoming vacation, Nuri invited to Ravi. Hey, please come and visit the Mizoram and see the greenery over there. Lush green surrounding of her place. So Ravi's teacher asked the student to draw the landscape, houses and activities of the people and the places they visit during the holidays. Now slowly the class was summing up and the class was speaking about what? That all the things which the student asked, the teacher replied, the classmate interact with each other, they had their conversation. The conversation after that, the teacher had given the homework to draw the landscape, houses and activities of the people which you have visited during the holidays. Their vacation, whatever they enjoyed, they have to draw it. Next, human beings should not learn the new ways. All this one we are going to talk about sustainable development. So what is sustainable development? Sustainable development is a development in that we are planning to use the resources without harming the nature and preserving that particular resource for the future generation. That is called as sustainable development. Proper planning to use the resource. Next, in this presentation, what is ecosystem? We studied. So it is a system formed by the interaction of all living organisms with each other. So all living organisms with each other, they are interacting and forming an ecosystem. So even the system, the energy flow will be the energy transferred from one to another. Last, we have seen the human environment. In the human environment, we have seen how the climatic condition, atmospheric condition, how the environment is varying from place to place. Why there is very too much hot and having the desert in Jaisalmer. Then why there is so much of greenery and so much of precipitation in Kerala. We have seen. So in the human environment, the human being is an important factor. Human being have to understand. Human being have to understand the value of environment and then utilize whatever the things present in the nature. So like that, the human being is a factor which is having the more and more responsibility to do the right conduct to preserve the environment. So moving further, I will give you a small homework. The small homework is that the overview, whatever the question has stated in between, you have to write it down. The questions are, what is ecosystem? What is ecosystem? You have to write the definition of ecosystem 2-3 times and you have to learn it properly. Then, what is human environment? And how the human environment is very important? And what is the role of human being to preserve and conserve of environment? And lastly, the topic of sustainable development. What is the meaning of sustainable development? And you should remember the story of Ravi. How the boy started to go to school, observe the area, and started to ask the question, doubt and difficulty to the teacher. And how the teacher also, with the love and affection and caring, with the proper guidance, she guided all the students, okay, why there is a need of change and for what purpose. It's a need or it's a greed. That's depend on the human nature. So let's see all these things by joining together. The point only speaking about our environment, we should preserve it. We should conserve it, and that's our responsibility. Next, I heartily thank each and every student, those who were watching this. I personally request you, please copy down the overview and write the points in your notebook and talk the creative idea to preserve and conserve the environment. Thank you to each and everyone. Jai Hind.